Once upon a time, I chaired the board of an organisation. And many, many years later, I returned to chair it again. What was really different the second time around was that I understood I was leading in complexity. I realised that there were limits to what we could control. It was a liberation. It freed us up to be much more creative. By complexity, I mean there were many situations where there were so many different people and groups involved, and so many variables, that there was no correct solution to be found. In these situations, it would be a waste of time and energy to be arguing at length over options or developing detailed plans or targets or trying to find the right answer. There was not a right answer to be found. It was much more useful to have a general direction and work things out as we went along. However, we were an organisation based on public trust. There were many things, like the ways we manage money or the safety of people working with us, that we had to pay very close attention to and ensure that they were done well. We had to get clearer about when to predict, plan and control, and when to explore, experiment and learn. This is the challenge and liberation of leading in complexity. We can put down the burden of trying to control things we cannot control. Instead, we can focus our attention and energy on shaping the direction and work of the organisation and letting it evolve, and pay close attention to where controls really matter. To do this well requires an understanding of complex adaptive systems, which is a fancy name for things we find all around us. Waves on the beach, traffic on the highway, family dynamics, organisational cultures. All of these are examples of complex adaptive systems. We live with them all the time. Let's take waves as an example. I'm lucky enough to live by a beach. Some days it can be totally calm. I can lay in the water and watch the sunset between my feet. Other days there are great waves for surfing. Or in storms, the sea can be a jumble of foaming, thrashing surf. Waves on the seashore are not just shaped by one thing. It's the interaction between elements like wind, tides, the swells generated far across the ocean, atmospheric pressure, the shape of the seafloor. It's constantly changing. We can look for patterns. We can expect the sea to be calmer or rougher, but we cannot predict what will happen wave by wave. In summary, waves are systems, because their form and character emerges from the interactions of these elements. This is just like what happens in an organisation or a community or your leadership team. The character of that community or team comes from the interactions between all of the elements. Waves and groups of people are complex because there are so many variables we cannot predict what will happen. But we can look for patterns. These patterns and systems adapt and change over time. Complex, adaptive systems. We cannot control the sea. Although we try to manage its effects by building breakwaters and better boats, but with people, with human systems, we can intervene. We can take action. We can try to make things better. But here's the thing. We imagine that we can control our team or our organisational culture. But that's an illusion. All we can really manage is to shape and nudge the system. We can set bounds, try experiments, and learn as we go. This is the liberation of complexity. We can give up on trying to control the uncontrollable and lean into experimenting and learning. In the next videos, I'll explore the elements of complex adaptive systems and how leaders and groups can use these to their advantage.